The city of El Paso has a policy of trap, neuter, return, or TNR, to manage feral cats. Under TNR, ferals are humanely trapped, spayed or neutered, and vaccinated, and then returned to where they were found. These cats are identifiable by a clipped ear. Sun City TNR board member Terry Guetta says because the cats are not adoptable, this is the only humane way to deal with them.
They need to be returned exactly where they were trapped, because that is their home, and it is against the law to trap them and dump them in other areas, because basically that's a death sentence.
Nonprofit advocacy group Sun City TNR is one resource to help El Pasoans with TNR. They teach people how to care for so-called community cats, among other things.
We help organize the trap, neuter, return. We educate any questions they have. We deal with the people that complain that don't like cats, and we try and educate them on being a compassionate community.
While Sun City TNR works countywide, some El Pasoans are enacting TNR programs in their neighborhoods. Co-owner of Camelot Corporate Condominiums, Bob Nyland, adopted a TNR program for his gated community in 2012 after reports that his neighborhood had been taken over by feral cats.
It got to the point when we went out to take trash out at night and put in the dumpster, cats would jump out.
Nyland TNR'd 37 cats, including 14 kittens, which were adopted out, and today only a handful of cats remain in the neighborhood.
Because they're so territorial, the ones that we brought back and that were spayed and neutered, they chose their territories, and they keep other cats from coming in.
Down below, we had the guys make the pen so that we could raise the kittens in there.
Nyland says the Camelot is an example of how successful TNR can be. Reporting for Borderzine, I'm Nicole Madrid.